Hi, I'm Peter Diel, and welcome to the Bellcrest Manor Estate, here high in the hills of Glendale, where we're celebrating the anniversary of the Jivin Jacks Jills, Universal's tribute to the wonderful musicals of the 30s and the 40s.
Hi.
Hi guys, how you doing? Hi, I'm Peter, who are you?
Vivian Austin.
Hi Vivian Austin, how can I get you to stand over here? Come on over on this side. Hi, Vivian Austin. It's your husband over here.
And my Lord and Master, Dr. Grove from Palm Springs.
The Lord and Master, Dr. Grove.
We drove all the way in for this.
From Palm Springs. Well, it's nice to have you here. What was your association with Universal?
Well, I made 20 movies for them, and I was there 5 years. And that was 195 years ago, but they're still playing on the Late Late Show. And I say anyone who stays up till 2 o'clock in the morning to see a movie deserves what they get.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Rita Quigley.
Hi, Rita Quigley. I'm Peter Diel. Nice to meet you.
How do you do?
Hi.
My daughter, Judy Sue.
Hi. How lovely. Hi. What was your association with Universal?
I wasn't. I was with MGM, but they were kind enough to include
me. Wonderful. What kind of shows did you do at MGM?
I did Susan and God with Joan Crawford and Frederick March.
Oh, how wonderful.
I did Blossom, the Ugly Duckling Daughter.
Mr. O'Gill, sir, how you doing?
Good. Nice to see you, Peter.
Nice to see you.
My God, I used to make westerns up here.
Isn't this beautiful?
It's beautiful.
What kind of shows did you do up here?
Everything. You started making silent pictures in 1918.
Whoa, what was your very first film?
He called His Brother's Blood. No, it was The Greatest Menace, I believe, with Angela C. Kaufman, the angel of the county jail. This is long before you were born.
Absolutely. Well, it's very nice
to have you. I was just 86 yesterday.
And a happy birthday to you, sir.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Peter.
I'm Ann Gwynn. And
Judy
Marshall. Judy Marshall.
Judy Marshall.
Trudy
Marshall. Well, nice having you here. What was your association with Universal or whatever?
Well, I was under contract to Universal for quite a few years. And Michael thinks I'm thought the greatest thing that's ever walked on two legs. And he's wrote a great big book, research work, about Universal. And I was the inspiration for that. And I was the Yanks pinup girl 2 years in advance for cheesecake and all that stuff. And Trudy Marshall was over at Fox.
Hi, I'm Peter. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet
you. Who are
you? Martha Tilton is my name.
Ah, nice to have you here.
And my husband, Jim Brooks, right over here.
Hi.
Well, it's good to be here. It should
be
fun today.
You. Hi, Mr. Brooks.
Peter, how are you?
It should be lots of fun today. We're looking forward to it.
Great. What was your association at Universal?
Oh, I made a couple of movies there long, long ago, and I dubbed for a lot of people at the time. I'm a singer.
Ah, who did you dub for?
I can't remember who I dubbed for. Isn't that terrible? It was several of the girls, you know, that couldn't sing very well, so they would get me, and I dubbed quite a few pictures at Universal.
It's Peggy Ryan and Tom Hatton. Wait, but Tom, you can't be here. You're on television right now.
That's right. Not until 3 o'clock.
Hi.
Hello.
Nice to see you. Nice to have you here. That's correct.
Good to be here.
I love...
should have worn my Western garb.
Oh, but you look terrific.
Thank you.
your little tap necklace.
Tap. My students gave me that.
All right. Yeah. You're teaching these days?
I teach the world how to tap dance. All the ladies in Las Vegas take from me. All the career women. Gave up martini lunches, babysitting, they do nothing but tap dance in Las Vegas. It's wonderful.
Well, it's nice having you here. We'll come chat with you later.
It's like our class reunion every year, you know, because we all went to studio schools, and this is really like our little college or high school reunion. It's marvelous. We look forward to it.
When did you start?
Start what?
Going to studio schools.
Right at the very beginning. I started when I was 3. You know, and then when I was with Donald, of course, we were at Universal. We were, I think we were in the 10th grade for about 5 years.
Hi, Tom.
Tom Hatton, Peter.
Hi, nice to meet you.
It's a thrill to be here, and I got to tell you that every year that this has happened, I read about it a week afterwards in Bob Osborne's column or somebody's column, and I said, by God, this year. So I called up Bobby Shearer, who, as you know, is one of the original Jivin Jacks Jills, and he said, get your tuckets over here, and all you have to do is promise to behave yourself. So I'm behaving myself. Anyway, I'm really against myself this afternoon because we have Cesar Romero on live on my show this afternoon. However, I am live here and delighted to be here, and I'm getting out of here.
Nice to have you here. We'll talk to you later. Hi, I'm Peter.
I can't
Peter.
Hi, Larry Peter. Ron Stanton.
Hi, Ron. And
Ann Watson.
Hi, Ann Watson.
How are you?
Hi. What was your association with Universal?
I was on the contract there with Don O'Connor, Peggy Ryan, Jimmy Vey, all the rest of the kids.
One of the original Jivin Jacks and Jills?
The originals.
Hi, nice to have you here.
Hello, nice
Hi.
To have you too.
Sybil Drake.
Hi,
Hello.
Sybil, nice
Hello.
To meet you. And
Tony Drake.
Hi, Tony Drake.
Yes.
Nice to have you here.
Nice to be here. Is Michael and everybody here?
Yes, people are here. What is the stage
Wonderful.
Pass for Celebrity Auction? Where
yes,
were you?
We were down at the Burbank Studios, my old...
Oh, that was Actors and Others for Animals.
Animals,
That's
yeah.
right. That's today's event
right.
going on here.
So we
Half
had a double
people
whammy.
People are down there wearing cowboy hats, and they'll be up here.
Oh, yeah. That's terrific.
Yes.
What was your association with Universal?
Not just my buddies or Universal. I was Warner Brothers' first kid star. And then after I left there, I went to Fox, and Shirley Temple and I made Little Princess and Bluebird together. I was Becky, the little gal up in the attic.
Hi, Frank Coughlin.
They call me Junior sometimes.
Hi, Junior. Hi. As long as they didn't call you Stinky, that was okay.
No, that was another one.
Oh, and what was your association with Universal?
Well, I made my first movie there in 1920.
What was it?
When I was 4 years old. It was either a Western with Tom Sanchez or a serial with Joe Bonomo, and I'm not sure which. But I know we used to ride the streetcar to the corner of Hollywood and Cahuenga and then hitchhike over the hill.
Well, things have changed a lot.
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah. Well,
it was a two-lane dirt road then.
How are you?
Okay, you're all sisters, right?
Oh, wish they were.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Peter. Who are you?
I'm Shirley Mills Hanson now.
Shirley Mills Hanson.
Right.
Okay.
Yes, and this is my two daughters, Rebecca and Denise.
Hi, Rebecca
Hi.
And Denise. And what was your association with Universal?
Oh, with Universal? Well, the first movie I made was The Underpup. I starred in it with Gloria Jean and Robert Cummings. And then after that, then I made quite a few pictures, like I was Ruthie Jode in The Grapes of Wrath. And I made some pictures at Columbia. And then I went back, while I was having braces on my teeth, I went back to Universal and made some of the Jivin Jacks and Jills movies. Did some dancing in there until I could go back to doing dramatic things again.
Hi, I'm Roy Clark.
Hi, Roy Clark. Nice
yes.
to have you here. What was your association with Universal?
I came a little bit out. I'm a guest of Shirley O'Mills. My first film was American in Paris.
Nelson. Boy. How you doing, Gene?
I'm fine. How are you?
Just fine, thank you.
Good.
Nice to have you here.
Thank you. This is you couldn't have picked a more out-of-the-way place, could you?
But it's a fabulous place and a great party going on upstairs.
Good. Can't wait to get there.
What was your first film at Universal?
Oh, my first film? I only made one film, So This Is Paris with Tony Curtis. I go back with Bobby Shearer, who was one of the Jivin Jacks and Jills, and Dottie Babbs. We were all in London here together. This was long after the Jivin Jacks and Jills.
It's Hal Bell. How
Hello,
you doing?
Peter.
Hi, nice to have you here.
Nice meeting you.
Gee, you know, I just found out recently that not only are you an assistant director extraordinaire,
mm-hmm.
but you used to be an actor dancer too.
Oh, that's definitely.
Part of
and
the
I was one of the Jivin Jacks and Jills.
I never knew that before.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That was back. I won't even tell when the year was.
Well,
hello.
Hi. Hi. Hello. You look lovely, too. How you
Tom
doing?
Irish. Thank you.
Hi, Tom.
Tom
Come on
Irish.
In.
How do you do?
I'm fine, thank you. How
Our
you guys doing?
Our chauffeur, a friend, this lovely
and
day.
And welcome to a beautiful place up here.
Oh, thank you.
It
thank
is
you.
Beautiful. Redwood trees and everything.
It's gorgeous. Where do you see the backyard?
You want us to go right now?
No, not yet. What was your first association with the Jivin Jacks and Jills or Universal or whatever?
I don't know. I began at Universal. I was under contract there.
When did you begin?
Oh, you really want to know? My first film, 1943, Corvette K225 with Randy Scott.
Ooh.
Yes, and I'm still on my own two legs.
Well, you look absolutely wonderful.
What else could you say?
Pretty good.
This is me now.
Yeah. Right there.
Right there. How are you?
Good. Hi, Marvin.
Nice to see you.
Nice to
Yeah, Jay died. I had to wish I knew.
I didn't want to come home from London. I'd rather stay there.
He's a stealer.
But I am not contagious. No, I'm not contagious, no. Hello, all you sweet people. So good to be here again.
Good.
It's fun. Oh, I love all those. Holy moly. That was 45 years ago. That's a hoot.
I was right behind you.
I know. Hello, sweetheart.
We still know who we are.
Oh, hi. Hello.
Hi.
Lovely to see you.
Nice to see you.
Oh, thank you.
Label you. We don't
right.
Everybody know who we are, but
oh,
you have to have a tag to be legal.
Yeah,
we're related anyway.
Well, that's great.
Eddie's
the oldest of six.
Only six? Only six, yeah.
You've been a busy lady, eh?
Yeah, fine. Nine grandchildren.
There's me. Well, Virginia.
It's a very special gift. I want your
kitties
to have the first
gift. Okay, here I go.
Eddie and I were together in The Grapes of Wrath. I played Ruthie Joe, the little girl with the pigtails. And Eddie, of course, was one of the close members of the Joe family.
I did whatever John Ford told me.
Right. And we were just discussing that Grapes of Wrath is going to be one of the first three movies that's going into Red China. So we were just talking about that. Wonderful to be here together today. Wonderful. Thank you.
Tom, it's good to see you.
Oh, thank you, Martha. I can't tell
you. I feel like I've seen it so much.
Well, how are you? Nice to see you.
Sober, and all that sort of thing. My wife,
and on top.
And you are the ET also.
Put Boston in the ET
too.
You took her.
Don't
Well, we don't live on Fisher Island. We live Indian Creek Island. It's
but the boat is basically. We can't dock the boat.
No, it's a postcard.
A friend of ours took this picture.
It looks like a postcard.
Yeah.
What does this party mean to you?
Oh, heaven. Sentiment. Hollywood. Oh, good Hollywood. Nice, special, thoughtful, sweet, conscientious, good people. It means a lot of things.
What kind of old friends have you seen here that you haven't seen in a long time?
Well, I keep up with an awful lot of people that I grew up with in the industry from 1932. And so I do see the majority of these people quite often, but there are a few that I only see here once a year. And that's always very exciting. Of course, I just love people, and I love all the people I've been privileged to know and work with. I came out here in 32, and I was about 5 and a half, and I'm 61 now. I'm just barely getting to a point of doing some of the things I've been waiting all my life to do, and I'm going to do.
Well, you look absolutely terrific.
Thank you.
And some of your...
I lost my voice. I don't really sound like this. I lost my voice 2 days ago. We just came back from a fabulous weekend of Legends of Entertainment. It's the first boutique Hollywood memorabilia store ever to open up. I'm trying to get the fans, the real fans, and the real stars together, because I think that's important. We've all had unique, wonderful, interesting lives because of what our careers have allowed us and because of fans and sweet people who care. I care a lot, and the majority of the people that I grew up with in the industry, they care too. And I think it's so neat, because I'm a collector. Boy, howdy, am I a collector. I'm known as a collector's collector. I have over 3,000 stills, over 1,200 lobby cards and posters. And we didn't get home last night till almost 1 o'clock in the morning, and to try to plow through even some of those things and get, because I wanted to have something of everybody here today. So this bag of goodies represents about 50 years of very special memories and sweet people. And I've already told, I said, I've got to get my tummy full first, because I'm about to starve, and then watch out, because we're going to share thoughts and have a wonderful time signing and exchanging autographs.
No, absolutely terrific. During all of your great films that you've made, do you have any one particular film that's your absolute favorite and why?
Oh, well, let's see. After 6 decades of films, let me think. Ginger, of course, Bright Eyes was very special to me because, let's face it, I'd waited a long time to be 6 and a half. I'd had such a career before then. I started at 2 and was known as Dixie's Danny Dewdrop in Atlanta, Georgia. I had my own radio show at 3 and had gone as far as I could go at 5 and a half in Atlanta, Georgia. Had to leave town and come to Hollywood. Of course, they couldn't have cared less. So I did about 100 films doing extra work. And finally, and of course, all the little girls they ever wanted on the interviews I went on were long, beautiful blonde curls and frilly dresses. And I've always been a plain Jane. What you see is what you always get. And I thought, please God, someday they're going to need an opposite to one of those beautiful little blonde girls. And when it comes, I know it's going to be my turn. And we heard, when we were doing a Marco Juvenile review. Judy Garland was one of the dumb sisters. She was on the show. Sidney Miller was our MC, precious Sidney Miller. Mickey Rooney was Mickey McGuire Comedies. He was on the show. Edith Fellows, marvelous singing voice. Leonard Seuss had a kid band. We were all on the show. We were short of $6 every Saturday night for that performance. We knew we could eat the next week. Anyway, the mothers were all sitting around talking. They said, hey, Mrs. Withers, they're looking for an opposite for Shirley Temple. And I said, I beg your pardon, what did you say? They said, they need an opposite for Shirley in a film called Bright Eyes. I said, God, I think my time has come. And sure enough, I got the part, and that's what did it for me. Then I signed my contract, grew up at Fox Studio for 14 years, and then I didn't like the films they were doing, so I bought out the rest of my contract, went to Republic, made 4 more, then got married, had 5 kids, did Giant. That's one of my super favorites as an adult. Ginger, though, besides Bright Eyes, was my first starring film at the age of 8. And Johnny Peroni and some of the kids that always were my gang in all of my films, they're here today. And I brought stills from Ginger and Pepper and a lot of the films that they're in that we're all going to exchange later on after I get my tummy full.
Think of this event.
I think if you like having fun, this is wonderful. Being a manic depressive, I don't care for it too much. It's wonderful. I just see a lot of faces I haven't seen over the years. It really is, it's a kick.
What does this mean to you?
It means a lot of fun. It means that I have a lot of friends, that we've established relationships over the years, and we've continued to like each other. That's an accomplishment in itself.
That's a great old memories.
Oh, and how. With all of these pictures, there's something that comes up about each one of them. For instance, I always talk about What's Cooking, the first picture I made with the Jivin Jacks Jills. And I don't even have billing. I was noticing this here. That's a put down. I don't think I'll come to the next party unless they change that poster.
What was the first film that you got billing in with the Jivin Jacks Jills?
I got in all of them, but it just happens that this poster is very funny. I don't know. But we made something like 12 pictures, 13 pictures together. Then they continued on after I went into service. Moonlight in Vermont, and Sidney Miller stayed in all those films, and I see them all on TV. Wish that I could have been in them.
Do you have any great favorites? Any particular favorite that stands out?
I think so. I think Mr. Big has to be the most fun. But the best fun of all was the Mary Monahans, because I didn't have to go to school anymore. Before then, it was a drag. I had to go to school, I had to learn dance routines, I had to go and do scenes, back to school again, rehearse, dance. It was really, when we worked 7 days a week, you know, people forget that. We worked at all hours, really. And at Universal, I had a way of getting around the child labor laws. So we had to have 3 hours of schooling, but we worked all the time. We were doing three pictures at one time, because after Mr. Big, I started becoming the Elvis Presley of my day, and I was going into service, and they tried to get in, pardon me, as many films as they could before I went into service. So we worked, just constantly worked, finishing up the picture before, doing the one we were doing, and rehearsing routines for the next one.
Boy, we're a lot of work. Well, thanks a lot for being here.
Maybe that's why everybody looks so good.
How you doing? What do you think of this party?
I think it's wonderful. I was sorry to miss last year's party. It's the first time they reached me. When you're out of business for 40 years, it's a little hard to find someone. But we were on our way on our boat up to Alaska last summer, so we missed it. But I had a year's notice for this one, so.
Oh, that's terrific. What kind of films did you do with the Jivin Jacks Jills?
Oh, gosh, I did so many. Let's see, I did Here Come the Coeds with Abbott and Costello, and Ghost Catchers with Olson and Johnson, and a lot of pictures with Noah Beery Jr., Allergic to Love, and then I did a picture called Dalton's Ride Again, and, oh, I don't know. There's so many, and it's so many years that I can't remember all of them.
Do you have any particular favorites? Anything just stands right out in your mind?
I really can't think. I was so busy having fun.
Okay, how about something off the wall? What was your most embarrassing moment during rehearsals? Obviously, you didn't show up on film. Any crazy stuff go on?
You know, I don't think. I was just too serious. I was well-read. I had my lines. I didn't make mistakes. I tried not to. I was always on time. I was just one of those little Miss Goody Two-Shoes.
Here we are, folks, some of the very best legs in town. Here we go. Okay, guys. Okay, here. Listen, I'm sure his legs are pretty good, too, but all the running around the directors have to do. Okay, guys, some very simple questions. Like, what do you think of this party?
It's a great party.
Really, isn't it wonderful seeing everybody that you haven't seen in so long?
Everybody.
Everyone's here. I haven't seen
it. It is a fabulous.
Well, Gene and I did have lunch together about a year or so.
Yeah. Well, what about me?
Yeah, we did.
We all get to see her.
You know what's
year.
So special is we did literally grow up together.
And we really look great now, don't we?
Don't we look marvelous?
I mean, let's face it. I mean, we're talking 40s.
Yeah, or late 30s.
I mean, we all made movies together, and this is like a great class reunion, you know, because we all went to professional school, and we'd see each other on a movie set or that, and now once a year we get to talk about our families, and we did great things with our lives, you know. We grew up, and, you know, after all of this wonderful fantasy
we're
land,
still friends.
Yeah.
That's very unusual.
And we're still short.
Yeah.
We never grew.
Well, I guess if I took my shoe off, I'd be on your height.
But we did realize that in the 40s, all the leading ladies, or comedians as I was, and dancers, were all short.
Right.
Now you see them, they're tall and lanky, but we were.
I am.
And this, of course, over here
is... generation. Have you seen our baseball players lately?
The greatest director ever,
right.
Mr. Dimitri.
Certainly.
And she happens to be married to this guy.
Happened to be my husband.
Yes.
Isn't that wonderful? But he has
been married 40 years. That's pretty good in this
town.
That's
not bad.
Very good.
Oh, that's a career in this town.
Yeah,
it is.
Yeah.
It's
well,
a career.
How long have you been married?
Well, I married for the first time 10 years ago. So I married a widower with four teenage children.
Well, I'm not ready to 30 years.
How about that?
Are you still married?
Yeah.
Hooray.
You bet.
Did you direct any of these, films?
Oh, he did.
Just this one. Yeah. That's how how we met.
Till the end of time.
That's
till
how
the end
we met.
Of, yeah. Mr. Dimitrixon did all of the big, wonderful pictures. We were down there tap dancing.
As a matter of fact, I was saying a little while ago, like everybody else, I started out in bees. I did about 17 of them in the 39, 40, 41. And a lot of the people that are here now, the only ones I see here now are the ones that I worked with in Bees, except for Bob Cummings. I did one with him.
Carpetbaggers.
But most of them are
Yeah, they're all here.
The A actors don't come here.
Oh, come on.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah,
that's enough.
That's enough.
Now you can talk to us.
Right. No,
I asked
her.
Jane and I starred together in Betty Coed, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Right.
We did.
That was a good movie.
Yeah. Well, I was with Donald O'Connor in a lot of pictures.
You sure were.
We had, they don't make pictures like that anymore, and they truly don't. You know, a good beginning, middle, and an end. And they were something very special. We learned our craft from the other people, the Jack Oakeys, the Lucas Dellos, and the wonderful directors and
Charlotte
the choreographers.
Greenwood. Is she here?
And I happen to be able to take that and go a step further because I'm teaching now and I'm going on with my career as a teacher in Las Vegas.
Peggy, I don't know why you mention those comics like Jack Oakey and people like that, because we have great comics now like Pee Wee Herman and Rodney Dangerfield.
Don't say that. They are marvelous. They are marvelous.
Okay, well, guys, thank you. Thank you very much. Enjoy. Enjoy.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I'm right behind you.
Well, how you doing, Vivian?
Hi, I'm fine. I'm having more fun. It's a wonderful party and so many old friends that I worked with at Universal.
Isn't it great?
Oh, yes.
What does this all mean to you?
Well, it couldn't have been that long ago. It seems to me just the other day to see all my friends and all these beautiful posters around of all my friends that we haven't run into in such a long time. I see them on the Christmas cards and so forth. So it's a very nostalgic day, and I'm here with my husband from Palm Springs and my daughter, and we're just having a ball.
Do you have any favorite films that you were in? Any special moments?
Well, naturally, Nightclub Girl was my favorite because it was my my first leading role at Universal. I had 15 leads there. I did 20 movies for them, but that was my first. And I sang and danced, and that was my first musical there. So that's my favorite, of course.
It means burning fire, deep water. I always say the burning fire gets me in the deep water.
Wow, what a great name. What kind
of name
is it?
It's Arapaho Indian. My mother was Arapaho. When I was at Universal Studio, it was Dan Kelly, the casting director. He said, are you going to be known as Brunu or Aquanetta? I said, let's go for Aquanetta. So that's just half of my name.
It's a lovely, lovely name.
Thank you.
What kind of films did you do at Universal?
Oh, gee, let's see. I did, of course, a Jungle series, Lost Continent, Rhythm of the Islands, Dead Man's Eyes, all kinds of things. The bread and butter ones that made the money. And then, of course, I did Tarzan and a Leopard Woman and Alone Out with Johnny Weissmuller. Well, that's a long time ago.
Sure was. What does this all mean to you, this kind of gathering?
Well, memories, yesteryear, beautiful memories, deja vu. I love it, every minute of it. I was so delighted when the invitation came. I thought, oh, wow, I'm going to see people I haven't seen for 30 or 40 years, and that's great. You know, some people don't even live 40 years, and I can look back on 40 years. Plus.
How terrific, and you look absolutely
Thank you. I have four gorgeous sons and two grandchildren now. So life has been very good to me.
We're going to do Billy Benedict and Bob Cummings.
I'm so happy that I was included and that there are no discriminatory practices. I never worked at Universal. I worked at MGM, Paramount, Fox, and my sister, I think they got me confused with. Her name was Juanita, not Rita, and she was under contract to Universal. Thank you for including me. I've loved every minute of it.
Well, it's terrific having you here. What kind of great films did you do over at MGM?
I played the ugly duckling daughter of Joan Crawford and Frederick March and Susan and God. That was my debut. And I won a nationwide poll as best supporting actress of the month. I was 16.
Oh, absolutely terrific.
I have many great memories from MGM, many great memories from the film industry. I'm sorry I haven't seen Dick Moore and some of the greats that have crossed our paths, but it's been a memorable occasion, and I thank Michael Fitzgerald and Mr. Bell for a wonderful, wonderful day.
I'm always very grateful to be with people who are just a little bit crazy. Always. It's so marvelous and warm and friendly. I wouldn't belong to any other industry.
What kind of friends have you seen here that you haven't seen in a while?
Well, let's see, Editor Maitre. Oh, goodness, you're asking me if I've been talking all afternoon. I can't even remember who I saw. Gloria Jean, Susanna Foster, and I used to pass each other on the lot and just say hello, but that was it. I'm rather disappointed not to see Martha Ray. I adore her and admire her so much. And Donald O'Connor. And we have some great people from those days. And they're still around.
What kind of great films did you make over at Universal?
Spring Parade.
Gee, I can't.
With Anne Gwynn.
Spring Parade with Anne Gwynn. Three smart girls grow up with Deanna Durbin. It started with Eve, with Deanna Durbin and Charles Laughton. And The Underpop with Gloria Jean. And let's see, Saboteur with Hitchcock. Well, he didn't play the part.
And, great actor, Robert Cummings.
Oh, there must have been others that I made.
lots. Well, terrific. It's nice having you here.
A great party. We're having a wonderful time seeing old friends and almost relatives because we're that close. We've been with each other for so many years, and it's just marvelous. It seems that time collapses when we all get together, you know. And all of a sudden, you recognize that nice smile or those pretty eyes or whatever they may be. It's just marvelous. I'm having a ball.
It feels wonderful to be here and kiss pretty girls and see people that I haven't seen in a long time. Some I have seen, I saw last year. But it's always good to see them, and I'm just having a wonderful time.
I'll just try to get in there. Amazing.
But I had more fun taking that bucket of water and throwing
it in his face.
Oh, no way.
It was a great number.
Yeah. Well.
And I'll tell you about what my father used to say when he used to take me to the films in the 40s, and he'd always go to a Virginia O'Brien film, and my father was very straight-laced man, very rarely laughed. And every time we'd leave the theater with a Virginia O'Brien film, he'd say, look at me and say,
That woman tickles me.
How neat.
That was it. I thought that was the height of flattery.
I think so.
That woman tickles me.
Well, how sweet. I appreciate that so much. Well, my dear father was very straight-laced, being the captain of the Los Angeles Police Department, Tom O'Brien. And my uncle Patrick Peter O'Brien was postmaster for many years. So I was brought up straight-laced also. So, you know, it came, I think what you're saying, it came through
the high flattery. That was his way of just getting hysterical over something very funny.
What do you think of the party so far?
I tell you, Peter, this is fantastic, and seeing friends that I do not see for a long time, or haven't seen. Am I using the right English? Being the mayor of Wrightwood, I better use the correct English. But it is so fantastic, and the dear man that put this on, and this gorgeous place, and I used to live in Glendale when I was a little girl, so I know Glendale, but we got lost finding this place. But it is wonderful, and goodness sake, I could mention names now that I can't. Well, of course, Janie Withers, I see her all the time, and Donald I see, and Margaret O'Brien, Civil Jason, I see that. But Eileen Barton, I haven't seen since New York, probably, should I say it, probably 40 years, or 35 at least. And like old home week, Peter, it's really wonderful. And I appreciate being asked, only doing one movie at UI, that wonderful movie I did with Donald, Francis in the Navy. And I bless him, because what a dear man he is.
Well, anyway.
There you are, Bonnie.
Hi, Gloria, can we talk to you?
Oh, certainly.
Terrific. Well, what do you think of this event so far?
Well, I think this is probably the best one we've had. We usually have a reunion every year, but this takes the cake, to see all my friends and everything. It makes you feel so good.
What does this mean to you?
It means that we will always be remembered, and it gives you a good feeling. It really does.
Do you have any very special memories of a particular film or something?
A lot of them that I did. A lot of the people that I worked with, like Bing Crosby and W.C. Fields, unfortunately, they're not around to say hello to. But there are a lot that are here, like Donald O'Connor and some of the people that I love, you know. So it is. It's special.
Beautifully. All the great people showed up, and couldn't have been better. It's been well worth it.
Why do you go through all of this and put this together? What a lot of work this is.
Well, partially because my mom got me involved with this, being one of the Jivin Jacks and Jills, and partially it's my way of kind of a payback for being able to appreciate all the films that were done by all these wonderful people during the 30s and 40s.
Well, you've done a great job. Everybody's been having a fabulous time here. Thank you very much.
It was my pleasure.
Okay, Michael, you and Gary go through an awful lot of trouble putting all this together. Why do you do it? Well, I just enjoy this. I mean, I love the old movies, the Universal of the 40s, and I love the people. And I go around visiting them once a year anyway, and this is a much easier way. Why not get them all together once? And they enjoy it, too, and it's terrific. It's fun. Yeah, everybody here is having a wonderful time. They seem to really enjoy getting together. But it's an awful lot of work, and we all appreciate it. Thank you very much. Thank you.
I would like to introduce you to an original Jivin Jack of Jivin Jack and Jills, okay?
Sure.
Dante De Paolo.
Yeah, hello. Hey, there you are. Hi, how are you?
David?
Did you know that I was an original Jack and Jill also?
No, I didn't know that.
Only Jack, not Jill.
Yes, I know. Two Jacks. Yeah. Two Jacks, and yeah, two I wasn't Jacks. Even a Jill. Right.
Well, that's right. Well, no. You were in your own way, in your own.
No, because you were great dancers, and I never could dance. Sang a little, but not danced.
Well, we had to have somebody dance too.
Yes.
What do you think of this affair?
This is wonderful. You know, I really understand when I read in the paper about Gloria Jean saying it was like a high school reunion. It's true, isn't it?
It really is.
Yeah, it's that time.
You see people you haven't seen for, well, I saw them last year, a lot of them. But before that, I hadn't seen them for 40 years.
I know.
42 years.
That's wonderful. There's some that you haven't seen, too.
Oh, you're not kidding. I mean, since we were kids.
I know. You see Donald and Gloria.
Yeah,
and,
I've seen them, but they're like Carly. I haven't seen since the movies. Donald, are you a Jack and Jill?
A Jack and Jill.
He was the star.
He's the jivinist. He's the jivinist of all.
We're going to go. You just got here.
I know. I have grandchildren. Have you?
You were here when the sun was here.
We'll see you, Mike.
Okay. Bye-bye.
All right, sweetheart. I'll see you.
Are you going to be here now?
I'm going to be in here for in town for another 2 weeks.
Oh, so am I.
All right, sweetheart.
Really?
Yeah. That'd be great. All right. When do you get your grandchild?
2 weeks.
2 weeks.
Oh, really?
4 weeks.
Congratulations.
I get another one in December. Isn't that great? Mancita.
But I made an awful lot of pictures.
Yeah.
In the old silent days, 1923, I was making pictures.
Oh,
and I made them up to 1950, about 1956. So you can imagine in that time, I made a lot of pictures. And,
yeah, look at us. We're the
musicals and dolls.
Right. Yeah.
And these dolls will always be up there in the calendar.
Ship afloat. Here is the story, human and intimate, of the Corvette men and the women they loved.
of men lashed by wind and waves, blistered by blazing decks, daring an inferno of danger for the women they know are waiting. A great cast, headed by Randolph Scott, James Brown, Barry Fitzgerald, Robert Mitchum, with Ella Raines, Andy Devine, Noah Berry Jr., and many other outstanding screen favorites, with their individual talents combined to bring you a magnificent motion picture.
A ship has it or hasn't got it.
Got what?
The thing you're talking about, me and the old man, we saw it once. We walked around, looked at them all from stem to stern. Then we sat down, looked at them again. And there she was, number 225.
Clear the ship! Get clear of the ship! She's gonna blow!
300.
Larry, I knew you were all right.
Wait a minute, what's this all about?
We just wanted to know what we think of you.
Never mind what you think of me. You want to know what I think of you?
What?
You're a crook.
Huh?
A chiseling crook.
What a terrific trio. Dan Duryea, slicker, smoother, more dynamic than in Scarlet Street. Ella Raines, who finds that playing with fire will make any girl run a fever. And William Bendix, so tough he'll steal your heart and your funny bone. In the story of a man who wasn't what he seemed to be, and a girl who would take a chance on anything.
We have no intention of buying you off, you know.
Buying me off? You sound like I was trying to blackmail you.
Well, that's the idea, isn't it?
Could he,
put me in jail? Yes.
Charles, we are in a mess.
We?
What do you think?
Put that picture back on the wall.
Picture?
Oh, yes. Right away.
Can you give it to me?
No, I'll do it. How's that, Mr. Lundy?
Okay. Nate?
Yes, boss?
Take care of him.
Was a special delivery. The sender, Ella Raines. The receiver, Rod Cameron. The picture, Universal's uproarious comedy hit, The Runaround, with Roderick Crawford as a slug'em and leave'em rival. It all starts when two private eyes, detectives to you, are ordered to find a runaway wildcat and bring her home unmarried and unkissed. A tough assignment? Oh, brother.
What are you going to do?
Knock you cold.
I believe you would.
Believe me, you can believe me. I'll give you 2 seconds.
I'm going home with Mr. Prentice.
Oh, no, you're not. I brought you halfway across the country, and I'm taking you the rest of the way.
Get out of here!
I can't. You weren't being kissed. I was holding you close so I could hear if you were breathing.
Was that all?
I get it the easy way or the hard way, Eddie?
Well, looks like you got me, Lou, but...
But what?
Just looks that way.